on the play for round two with a keep. It's not exciting. We have what the deck presents us, which is two on flyers for two mana and the removal spell plus dragons. Okay, so playing against another control deck. Or maybe, I don't know. Here I can play Stratus Dancer, or I just pass the turn. If I hit all my lands up to 5, I might be able to play Stratus Dancer. I think it's better to play Rattle Chains first, because if I draw another Rattle Chains, then it's better having them in play. Here I think I'm gonna play Stratus Dancer Morphed, because my opponent cannot Languish, which means that next turn I can leave my untap for Dimensional Infiltrator and unmorph a Stratus Dancer, which is quite good. Or I can just kill the morph. Alright, Nissa Vast Vizier. I really want to draw land now. It's a top land, yet again, thing that I didn't want to happen. Because the thing is, if I'm Draconic Roar my opponent's Nissa, and then I cannot counter the Languish. So I think I'd rather just attack with Rattle Chains and pass. And if my opponent, I don't know, just doesn't seem great to me. Yes, yeah, so attack on another block. Hopefully it plays a spell, like Read the Bones also. Tireless Tracker. Yes. Okay. What do we do now? We can either just play Draconic Roar on Tireless Tracker. Yes. We'll play Draconic Roar on Tireless Tracker and then attack, leaving mana tap for Dimensional Infiltrator and the other card, the Morph. I will reveal Thunderbreak here. It's a little less surprise effect than Icefall. Icefall is just a removal spell also. Okay, so here, keep attacking. Yeah, if I had played turn 3 Dimensional Infiltrator, it would have been better, I think. I would attack for two more, and this turn I would have. But the thing is that I drew only lands. I only had two lands, three lands, so it was not clear that I was about to draw those lands. Okay, Kalithas. Yes. Kalithas is good. On the other hand, though, if I unmorph this morph and then play dimension, yeah, let's go with flyers. Play this. It's a 7 damage coming across that he cannot block. And then I can also just play Icefall in order to not gain my opponent the life. But then, because the thing is that Thunderbreak is very bad against Languish. So I'd rather just, since my opponent is on 2 life, I'd rather just play Icefall here and not let my opponent gain 3 life, and then if my opponent happens to have a Languish, we're gonna just play Thunderbreak, which is going to kill my opponent unless he has another Languish, which is gonna clear all the tokens. So I think it's the best plan for me. So Languish here need to happen. Okay, since my opponent is on 2, we cannot spot removal spell the Thunderbreak. He has to Languish again. Oh, Silumgar Scorn is perfect. And cannot use it right now when it's on the stack, but now it's a counter spell. Great draw. plant on two life, only get out of this with another language, I think. Let's see. Block one. Yep. Cast. And this should do it. Let's see if I'm missing something, but there are no, I mean, you can play full tongue evocation, but I don't think that's the case. Okay, good. My plan worked. I elect out to go. Again, I board in favored visions. I think my opponent is on the slow plan. An electric roast. I wanna maybe also negate. Let's cut the Dratiska spawner again. Not the best. Not the best against Languish. Let's also board out. Maybe I think I don't like any of those dragons against the Languish deck. If I do a thing like this, let's just try if the cards were if the cards are enough. The cards are not enough to do. The cards are not enough to board out all the dragon package. Inferi Impulse is good against Nissa and Tracker, but Draconic Core on the other end just deals 3 damage, which is very important. And also, maybe I'm fine just boarding out two Silumgar's Scorn, but on the other hand, those Silumgar's Scorn kill. Also, it's a spot removal spell. It's a daze, which is a kind of a spot removal spell if played on his Kalithas on turn 4 or Languish on turn 4. So it's always good. I'm on 62. I need to cut something. I might just cut the negates. I have a little bit of counter spell, and I think a Clash of Wills is slightly better. Yep, let's go. Let's collect that. On the draw, this end is a. It's a, not exciting. I'll keep, though. We have a turn 2 Clash of Wills, turn 3 Fevered Visions, and we can basically draw one of the 12 Vaporkin that we have. But we didn't. So hopefully I'm able to counter something here. Wouldn't be the best if my opponent doesn't play any 3-drop. Just wasting my turn 2 with a deck with so many 2-drops. Yeah, kind of a shame, but that's what it is what it is. Let's start the Fevered Visions time. So now everyone's gonna draw 2 cards, and if my opponent has. Let's read it together. Everyone's drawing 2 cards. Sorry, 1 card extra at the end of the turn, and if my opponent has 4 or more cards, it's gonna take 2 damage, which my opponent is basically doing. Yeah, just play the land and pass it. Here I have quite a lot of options. I can go Draconic Roar and Dimensional Infiltrator, which is the best to me. Opponent f6. I think I will Draconic Roar. Can you do something? No, there is not. There is no Dramaka Comment. So yeah, let's just pass here. I'm gonna draw an extra. Oh yeah, no, I'm gonna draw an extra card. So I have to. But maybe I can do something here. Draw an extra card, and if it's a dragon, I can deal 3 damage. It is not. So let's just cast this now. Okay. I didn't want to discard even if I have so many lands, still don't want to discard those. Opponent didn't play anything last turn, so might have something here. It is just that with 2 mana up. Why? Okay. Playing a flyer and drawing for the turn. Yes, let's attack here. Do I just want to exquisite Firecraft that thing? I think I want to keep all the exquisite Firecraft for my opponent. If my opponent wants to draw extra card with the tracker, I'm totally fine with that. I can also just exquisite Firecraft my opponent right now. I think that I like that line. That's just for you. Then opponent would draw a card. Opponent is gonna take two more damage from the Fabled Visions, and we're gonna play an additional flyer to the board. Grasp. Sure. Advocate. Okay, so he's playing around Clash of Wills. He's gonna go down to 8, down to 6, and then, he's probably gonna die. I don't think we are going to die here. Opponent has on the table 4, 8, 11 damage. A bit of a counter. I think I just want to play a land and untap land so that I can Clash of Wills or whatever. And just take the damage not to die. And then I'll play as good Firecraft targeting you. I can also play a morphed Stratus Dancer, which is basically countering whatever. Oh, my opponent can't kill me with the tracker. That's important. So if I pass here, I'm just dead. Opponent has a land, crack. No, he doesn't have the mana to crack two clues and activate the Easing Quagmire. But if he plays another Sylvan Advocate, it's the same. No, so if it's Sylvan Advocate, it's 7 plus 6, 13. So it's exactly lethal if he plays a Sylvan Advocate. So I have to play around that a little bit. And how do I do that? I mean, if he plays a Sylvan Advocate, though, I clash up with that. And he can't activate Async Quagmire and have... I also have Rattle Chains to block. Yeah, okay, I have the plan here. Let's just play Island and say go. Ruinous Path Debt. I don't mind. Maybe though, if my opponent has a... if he has a Duress, we just counter the Duress. So the Exquisite Firecraft is gonna finish him off. Most likely. Take 7, sure. I have to keep the Clash of Wills for the Duress. All right, down to 4. We untap and Firecraft him. Bang. Oof. This deck seems like a blast. One showed me his hand, which basically was all good stuff, but we have this Favorite Visions, which dealt him, of course it's good stuff, he drew two cards per turn, but this Favorite Vision dealt him so much damage during the course of the game, and a deck without a clock was not able to do it. So yeah, good game, good deck so far.